Good afternoon. I'm your host, Gospel Mellow, and you're tuning in now on the Gospel on Demand. I'm sitting here with my pastor to the right, Reverend David J. Venable, and Deacon on the side of him. And he come down and showed me some support. I'm going to interview him in a couple minutes. And thanks for tuning in, first of all. Praise God. I'm so excited today. It's an honor to be here. I'm the voice of the youth. This show will be discussing crimes dealing with the youth, sharing community events, church events, school events, charity events. I'll probably play a couple gospel songs, inspirational music, having free giveaways, fundraisers, sharing testimonies. If you need a prayer request, call us 202-292-0072, while we had the pastor right here beside me. And we're going to start. Matter of fact, it's October 7th, and we will. But it's October 7th. Hold on 1 second. We're having technical difficulties. Okay, now, welcome back. Yeah. Well, I just want to acknowledge Breast Cancer Awareness Month. It's a big deal here in the United States and everywhere. I have some symptoms and some signs of breast cancer for the women out there. We have to take care of our women, because without women, there will be no men. Symptoms and signs of breast cancer. Even if I tell the symptom and you're having it, doesn't mean that you have breast cancer, but you do need to go see a doctor. First symptom, how your heart and breast and nipple feel. How your breast and nipple feel. Any lump in the breast, maybe under the arm, change of skin texture, nipple tenderness. That's the first symptom. Second symptom, breast cancer or nipple appearance. Any unexplained change in size or shape of the breast. Unexplained swelling, and so on and so on. Anything abnormal with your breast, go see the doctor. Third symptom, nipple discharge. Clear discharge, bloody discharge, go see a doctor, because it could be a sign of breast cancer, but we're no doctor, and we all believe in God here. Amen. And let's just go ahead to the interview. Well, I'm about to interview Pastor Reverend Dave Venable. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, my friend. How are you, man? I'm excited for you. I'm proud of you, man. Keep up the good work. Calm down. Relax. You'll be good.
Yeah, I'm a little nervous. God guide me.
Yeah, he got you.
Okay, Pastor. How many years have you been a pastor?
Well, I've been pastoring now for 4 years. I've actually been preaching going on 9 years. Been pastor. I started True Life Redemption Ministries Mother Day 2008. Started in a banquet hall. Then God blessed us to move in a storefront church. And 2 years later, we purchased a sanctuary in Clinton, Maryland now. I'm the pastor-elect of Cathedral of Christ in Capitol Heights, Maryland, where I plan on being there for the next 25, 30 years.
Okay, second question. What made you become a pastor?
God made me become a pastor. Truth be told, like I tell a whole lot of folk, if it was up to me, I would not be in this field, amen. But nonetheless, his will be done, not mine. Being a young man, I became pastor at the age of 27 years old. Being a young black man, I had a whole lot of stuff I can be doing, you know, other than pastoring in a church or preaching the gospel. But God saw fit to do something different. God saw fit and to give me a different path for my life. So I accepted a call of preaching at the age of 20. I accepted the call. I ran for some time, but then God really set me down and said, this is what I will have for you. And since I've accepted the call, I just been overwhelmed with blessings, and I appreciate it.
Okay. Okay, well, you know we have the election coming up, and it's a big deal Obama made an announcement that he supports gay marriage. And I want to ask you this question. How do you feel about Obama announcing that he supports gay rights? And as a pastor, do you feel that it will affect the votes of Christians?
I will say that one thing I do notice first of all, let's get on Obama. I'm in full support of President Obama. I think he's the right man for the job. I know that we are moving forward and we can't look back. I believe that that Governor Mitt Romney will take us back with outdated policies and things that would not appeal to the Afro-American community, not alone Afro-American community, but the United States as a whole. I think that he's not the answer at all. I believe that President Obama was in a situation where he had to make a decision. He was forced to announce his support. Believe it or not, it's a lot of past presidents and a lot of folk in Congress and in the senators and governors now who support gay marriage, but they are unforced to make that announcement like President Obama has made it. I would say that one thing that I noticed about the church, we focus on one sin, amen. It's not that am I a support of gay marriage or am I support of adultery, I'm support of fornication. It's no, we should be against all sins, amen.
Amen.
And we should denounce any sin and we should always preach repentance. So we try to focus on gay marriage, but it's sin as a whole, you know, and I do believe that we need to focus on repentance and not focus on one thing. A lot of times we focus on that same-sex piece, you know, when it all is bigger than same-sex marriage, bigger than fornicating, whatever. So I will say this, I believe that the strategy of the Republican Party was to get President Obama to announced that he was in support of gay marriage, and what it was a trap to have the black churches not to come out and support, amen. Because one thing that we will focus on is the gay marriage in the church, yeah. And once you say gay marriage, oh, we protesting, we fighting, you know, but we're not protesting any fornication, you know, and not by any imagination. Am I with gay marriage? No, I'm not a supporter of gay marriage, but I don't think that one thing should stop us from voting for President Obama. And I pray and hope that we do get out and vote in spite of this one thing that we do not agree with. Amen. But we do go out and support President Obama and be a voice. Even if you don't support President Obama, go out and vote, period. Amen. Mm-hmm. We fought tears and shed blood so that we had the opportunity to vote. So even if you do vote for Mitt Romney, just go out and vote, period. So.
All right. Excellent answer. Well, question 4. I've seen a lot of young adults look up to you. Since I've been going to your church for a little bit over a year now.
Mm-hmm.
And I just have a question. Why do you think so many young adults look up to you?
First of all, I have a passion for young adults. I have a passion for the inner city youth. I began coaching at the early age of 19 years old, coach high school football, and I grew a passion for the inner city youth. And even when I became a school teacher, I've always been that cool favorite teacher, you know. Being a young teacher, it made the student gravitate towards me and wanted to be in my class. So I took that same attitude and that same approach into pastoralship. What gets me by and the way I'm able to relate is that I stay updated, I stay reachable, I stay close to the flock. Amen. And what I mean by that is when you get close to me, I'm going to smell like the sheep because I'm around the sheep. So and they want a leader who they want a pastor who is touchable, reachable, one they can relate to. And I try not to become outdated, become old per se, amen, praise God. I try to at least be around them so that I can pick up through their lingo, you know, and make sure that I'm preaching a message that they can understand and can really relate to, because it's no secret that when you hear me preach, you will think that, wow, you know, he's an English teacher. Sometimes I say words that you'd be like, wait a minute, now you know that's not the proper way of doing things. Amen. But yeah, I'm an English teacher, but I know how to adapt in the environment that I am in, you know. And I think that they can appreciate that they can find themselves in the message, they can find themselves in the Word of God, and they can really stand on what they found themselves in.
All right, like that slogan, what'd you say, Mo?
Yeah, what's up, Mo? I'll say that in the pulpit. What's up, Mo? Drop it like it's hot. I got to change that one. They're kind of outdated, so I'll find something. That's my new thing is, anybody got time for that? That's Sweet Brown right there. Amen.
Right. I heard you say great followers make great leaders. Mm-hmm. Are there any pastors or reverends you look up to?
First of all, I do believe that in order to be a great leader, you got to be willing to follow. There's a lot of folk in the body of Christ and a lot of folk in life in general who want to lead but don't want to follow. Amen. You want to be in authority but don't want to be under authority. So in order to be in authority, you have to be under authority. And yes. I believe that one of my greatest attributes, I learned how to listen and follow. Amen. And it makes me an effective leader. So in saying that, I think that my all-time favorite pastor, pretty much who I just love to hear is Bishop T.D. Jakes. I'm a fan of him. I've heard every preach, every word. You know, I'm a big fan of him. So that's my somewhat of a TV evangelist that I like. But ones who's here at home and ones who's close to me, of course, is two that I really really enjoy and really really idolize is. Three. One of the ones is Reverend Tony Lee from Community of Hope. I really appreciate him. I think that he relates to the young folk really well. He's a great preacher. He's got the Hip Hop Nation going on with the other radio station. I don't know if I can say it here, but he's got that morning radio station going. And then our overseer, Pastor Calvin Cage, his wisdom, amen, the way he put together his sermons and the way he can relate to the older generation and the younger generation is like phenomenal. I think that he's very, 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 very intelligent, full of wisdom. And also, finally, Bishop Staples. I mean, I just see Cathedral of Christ really growing into Temple of Praise over the Capitol Heights Virgin, man. When he comes out for service, it's like ready. It's like on and popping. You know, he's an awesome, awesome anointed man of God. So I really do like those three: Reverend Tony Lee, Bishop Calvin Cage, and Bishop Glenn Staples from Temple of Praise.
All right. Okay, we're gonna go ahead.
And you. Me. Yeah, I look up to you, man. You awesome, man. Keep it up, man. I'm very proud of you,
thank
man.
You. Yes, I appreciate
sir.
You.
Yes, sir.
I appreciate your help.
Yes, sir.
All right, we're going to take a 5-minute break. I need everyone to enjoy Lean On Me by Kirk Franklin, R. Kelly, Murray J., Bono, and Crystal.
This is for that little child with no father. For that man that doesn't have a place to stay. For that little boy living with AIDS.
Can I tell you a story? Tell you a story.
You can lean on me.
There's a man, oh yeah, standing on the corner. He has no home. He has no food. And his blue skies are gone.
Yes, it is.
Can you hear him crying now?
Here's my shoulder.
Here's my shoulder. You can lean on me.
Hallelujah.
He loves you more than you'll ever know.
Instead of walking away, open up.
Open up your heart and say,
come on.
Was Kirk Franklin, Lean On Me, one of my favorite gospel songs of all time. Very inspirational. Okay, just in case y'all didn't hear me, I'm going to say this one more time. This is October, and this is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. And I take this disease very seriously, even though I'm not a male, but I'm still concerned about it. And
even though you are male, you're concerned about it. There you go.
Actually, even though I am.
Okay. Amen. Amen. You got it.
Oh, I am a male.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Okay. And I just have some signs and symptoms of the breast cancer that you should be aware of as a female woman. No. And it's three symptoms that pastor going to read.
Amen. once again, like he said, breast cancer is a very serious matter. In fact, there's someone who just had their surgery to remove their breast. Amen. I send out prayers to her. Amen.
Amen.
Stay strong. Amen. The symptoms and signs of breast cancer. First of all, you can go to nationalbreastcancer.org to find out these symptoms. Women should first of all get screened regardless if you have symptoms or not. But before I tell you the three symptoms, I just want to tell you signs. Just because you have these symptoms does not mean that you have breast cancer. Amen. One of the first symptoms is the first symptom is how your breast and nipple feel. Any lump in the breast, maybe under the arm, change in skin texture, nipple tenderness. So examine your breast. If your breast doesn't feel normal, amen, normal to you, amen, then you may want to get that checked. Another symptom or sign is the breast or nipple appearance. If the appearance looks different, any unexplained change in the size or shape of the breast, dimpling anywhere on the breast, unexplained swelling of the breast, especially on one particular side, unexplained shrinkage of the breast, anything that does not look ordinary, you may want to get that breast cancer, that breast screened. Third symptom sign is any nipple discharge, that you're not familiar with, particularly clear discharge or bloody discharge. It is also ever so important to note that the milky discharge that is present when a woman is not breastfeeding should be checked by her doctor. Amen. So keep in mind those particular symptoms and signs. Amen. And then for more information, you can always go to nationalbreastcancer.org to really tackle this really painful and dangerous disease. Amen. We'll keep those lifted. Amen. Don't forget to wear your pink this month.
Yes. Well, I would like to, I have a prayer here. It's called the Prayer of Healing.